Please join us going around the outside of Vancouver Island, crossing around dreaded Cape Scott, and then north, going completely around Prince's Royal Island. We hope you enjoy the trip as much as we do. Port Alberni offers a wonderful train ride to a 50s and 60s steam-powered logging show, a must-see if you're in the area.
Pipestem in Lucky Creek. Marvelous. Are you okay? Yeah. Heath! Be careful!
matter how hard you're working.
You gotta get this one in the book.
The crab pots are set.
Put this on the video.
And we're waiting for them to fill up with delicious Dungeness crab.
Old style.
The Marble River offers an incredible ride through rock-faced cliffs and fantastic scenery. This is a must-do with your dinghy.
Isn't this neat? Rock right there.
Right over here now.
Oh, going right over it. Thank you.
sure and stop in at the Westview Marina for a delicious lunch and wonderful service. We really enjoyed our stop over here.
Hi, man.
Somebody, please volunteer.
Hey!
Hello!
Family
hello.
Dinner!
Just a little snippet.
And while you're up,
here, Jim. Right, there's a little bit.
What a treat to see these beautiful dogs.
Woo.
We named Wolf Dogs as they were waiting for a treat from us.
They're beautiful. Wow. Wow.
Queen Cove, the gateway to incredible salmon fishing, but also beware, there are hidden dangers in this bay, as you will see in the following clips. While sitting idling, waiting for others to arrive in Queen Cove, we backed up and got caught in submerged lines, probably old logging lines. So when you go into Queen Cove, you better be ready to untangle these lines. Fortunately, one of our captains was fully equipped with diving gear, and after two tanks of oxygen, he cleared the lines from our propellers.
Jim, that's the biggest thing we've caught this trip.
Got it.
We'll be right back.
guys still hearing about?
Winter Harbor, a very pleasant stopover and a gateway to the Salmon Highway just outside of Winter Harbor. Crossing around the dreaded Cape Scott and on to Bull Harbor for some wonderful salmon fishing off the point of Vancouver Island.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, come on now.
Don't pull him out of the water, Gary.
Pull him up.
Just go around this thing. Go right over the rigger.
Oh.
There, we got it. Ah, damn it.
Oh, man.
That's better.
Damn.
I can't get it any higher. I can't get it any higher.
Stick all right, it out good. There.
Thank you.
Come on. Hey.
Yeah, there you go. Holy shit. Worn out.
Look at her. Nice there fish, mate. Jeez.
Alright.
Got you now.
And the camera.
Oh yeah, she's on.
Concluded the first leg of our trip with our wonderful companions and had our final dinner at Port McNeil. We then pushed on north by ourselves to circumnavigate Princess Royal Island. If catching coho salmon is your thing, then fishing at the head of Hackeye Pass near Joe's Salmon Lodge is the place to be. Codville Lagoon offers great anchorage and a wonderful hike to Sager Lake. It's an easy hike. Just remember, be aware of bears and be properly prepared. trail used to be a muddy slog, but now it is beautifully lined with 2x12 wooden planks laying side by side where there used to be nothing but mud. If you look carefully at this video, you will see the planks outlining the trail. Sager Lake has a beautiful beach with the brown colored water from the cedar. Shearwater has been our favorite stopover for fuel and supplies for many years. Across from Bottleneck Lagoon is Waterfall Point. Be sure and give this a good look. It is truly a beautiful waterfall. And with the drone, we get a look at the top that's feeding this wonderful sight. From Waterfall Point, we traveled north to Coots Inlet. This is arguably the most beautiful anchorage on the west coast. With an incredible waterfall, grizzly bears on the beach, seals playing in the sand, abundant Dungeness crab, and the Coots River. We spent 3 days here. I always hate to leave this beautiful sight. Thank you.
Man, we got a lot of crab.
On the flight back down the Coots River Delta, we'll drop down to 50 feet and cruise over the bog and sand. This area is normally covered with seals, but today, for some reason, there are no seals present. In a moment, you'll see why, as we pan down a narrow channel to the left. If you look carefully, you will see a large grizzly bear walking just out of the water into the bog. I didn't realize I had this shot until I got back to the boat. Now you can see the grizz if you look carefully. Just beyond the grizzly is a bald eagle sitting on a rock. Look closely now. You'll see him coming up. See the white dot? There he is, waiting, waiting, waiting for breakfast. And off in the distance is CJ, stern tied in front of the beautiful Coots waterfall. Next, we traveled north about 15 miles to Buttedale. Buttedale is a ghost town that was founded on Princess Royal Island, British Columbia in 1918 as a fishing, mining, and logging camp. Initially, the salmon cannery was established by Western Packers, which was then purchased and operated by the Canadian Fishing Company until it ceased operations in the 1950s. This beautiful site has been purchased by a private party with the plans of turning it into a major stopover marina resort. Please enjoy the drone overview of Butte-Dale.
Is it working now?
Well, I just turned it on. You want me to run it again?
Yeah. And this generates a megawatt?
Yeah, these two turbines together, when the pipeline's restored and the generators are running at peak efficiency, in 800 kilowatts, that's the minimum.
Wow.
They can run.
And now we will travel north to Hartley Bay, then turn west to go outside of Princess Royal Island and down along the rugged west coast. Please be aware when you're in this region, you're all alone, so you must take necessary precautions. Thank you. During our trip, there were major forest fires about 100 miles inland in British Columbia. As you can see here, the smoke is even going as far west as the Pacific Ocean. Anchored alone in Penn Harbor, there was abundant Dungeness crab. We noticed on the way in that our chart showed the entrance to be blocked, but the chart is wrong. There's plenty of room for easy entrance into this peaceful, beautiful harbor. At the head of Surf Inlet is an abandoned hydroelectric dam. It was once the home of a copper mine. A very interesting overview with our drone shows the large lake above the dam. This lake was aptly named Cougar Lake. We then traveled south to beautiful St. John Harbor, one of our favorite fishing holes. In a small back bay, we met some wonderful people who spend the summer there fishing and having great dock parties. Traveling back northeast, we anchored in Ellerslie Bay. Truly beautiful spot. Great crabbing and wonderful scenery. You'll see here the drone flying over this ridge. Behind this ridge hides a waterfall. You can get in here with a dinghy at high slack tide, but be careful. It can be a rocky ride. Next, we headed south to Ocean Falls. Ocean Falls is a community in the central coast of British Columbia, formerly a large company town owned by Crown Zellerbach. It is only accessible via boat or seaplane and is home for a few dozen people. This power plant supplies power to Bella Bella and Shearwater. Cruising over the hydroelectric dam in downtown Ocean Falls, there is a beautiful little marina, well maintained. A great stopover spot. Going on up the inlet, we will enter Martin Valley, where there are still many homes inhabited by a few of the residents. We'll be right back. Next, we traveled south to Lizzie Cove, where we were met with Peter, Rini, and Teresa. We will never forget their wonderful hospitality during our 3-day stopover.
I've been waiting for this.
The camera.
Yeah. Now starting the fire. So you rub two sticks together. How long do you have to rub them together?
I love this. 8 liters. You know, a lawn rake, you know how many marshmallows it roasts at one time?
How many?
11.
Oh, fire is perfect.
Perfect one.
Yeah, when these guys were here last time.
If you want to cook a steak, now's the time to slap the steak right on the coals. Right on the coals.
Next, we went south to our favorite annual stopover, Sullivan Bay. Sullivan Bay offers a fully stocked general store, liquor store, full service fuel dock, and 3,000 feet of beautiful moorage. But best of all, the managers, Chris and Debbie, are so wonderful and take care of your every need. We've been going here every year for 30 years and can hardly wait to get back there next summer. Make this a must-do stopover. Here is Chris waving to me on the dock. He's a great guy.
You look good right there.
There's nothing like Little Nemo Resort on the planet Earth. A 5-star resort with great hospitality. This day, we stopped over for a massage, a glass of wine, good conversation, and hors d'oeuvres. Truly a magnificent place to visit.
Thank you.
Well, good to see you guys here.
Oh my God. How can we get you in it?
This is just great.
Yes, we miss you.
Beautiful experience. Nemo.
We wouldn't be here if it wasn't for Jim.
Oh, right.
Nemo Spas, the best.
We'll see you later.
Bye.
I'm panning both ways. There's no way out, guys.
This is it. It's a long.
Entering Napa Lagoon through Roaring Hole Rapids. This shows us going through at slack tide. Easy peasy. But now we're going to go through on flood tide. Certainly not max flood, but a pretty good flood. Don't try this unless you really know Roaring Hole and you have a very seaworthy boat. Next we went to Turnbull Cove, a great secure anchorage with good holding, and a trail to Hoxton Lake. This trail used to be used for logging. Follow the trail through the deciduous trees and see the beautiful lake behind it. It's a short walk, but remember, there are bears. The next few days, we moved back to Sullivan Bay and tried our hand at salmon fishing in Wells Passage. It proved to be a great adventure.
You like something on there?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Feels like it?
Yeah. You want to get it away from that?
He's still there. You got a fish.
Yeah. I'll show you how to do it. You always grab the metal like this.
Nice job, Mark.
Come on. Come on. Yeah, a lot of pair.
It's a fish. Yeah, I'll try it. He has a mind of his own.
Hold your pole up. Don't point it, Mark.
Okay.
Attaboy.
No! No! No!
No!
Keep reeling.
Keep them reeling. Queer legs.
Oh my gosh.
That's a good fish. Keep the rod up. You're doing great. Just kind of gently bring him around. That's a nice fish.
Yes! Oh, happy day!
Look at that!
Nice. Happy fish. Way to go, Mark.
Oh, yeah. Come on.
And he's on the phone doing business. I'm getting on the phone and doing business. That's a secret.
Atta boy.
It got away.
You sure? No, you keep reeling. Keep reeling. He could be swimming right at you.
Yeah, especially if loose that up.
No, he's gone.
So when he pulls, you take your hand off the rod, just palm the bottom when he pulls. Alright, so I want you to walk backwards for me. Pull a little bit. Oh, that's a nice fish. Take a little bit more line in, unless he pulls.
Well, it is a nice fish.
Reading gear still?
No.
That is a spring salmon.
That's
the rod. I probably should, huh? Where I get above that roof.
There you go. Okay, come right here.
There we go.
We got him. Oh, look at that.
Nice fish.
Lots of energy.
Well done.
He's long.
Give me five.
Yeah! Come on.
Nearing the end of our summer trip, I wanted to top it off with a cruise on my Sea-Doo to Broughton Lagoon. This is a very interesting trip and a tricky entrance. Don't try this unless you really know the water and you really know how to ride a Sea-Doo.
You went out so soon.
You know what? He's starting to pick up already.
It's still coming in.
Yeah.
Well, it's not full flood yet. It's going to go totally slack and then start out.
Yeah, oh, okay.
Yeah. Anyway, do you want to go through the backside? We can.
No.
No. Okay. All right. Well. Okay. Do you have any water on board?
Yes. Want some?
I want to rinse my glasses off.
We got to play with the dolphins a little bit.
Oh, you did? I didn't see them.
You were going too fast.
Let me just pour a little on my glasses, yeah, and then I'll be done. Want to hold the cap? Thank you. Uh-huh. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Oh, I went way back in there and talked to the squatch.
I thought I'd do that before you were headed.
I saw a dolphin, but I went over there and it didn't come around.
There were about four of them, and we kind of came at them, and they would go underneath the bow of our boat,
oh,
and then disappear, but they wouldn't play in the wake or anything, which, you know, sometimes
you can go way back in there.
It looked like it.
Yeah, okay. All right, well, it's such a nice day.
It's a gorgeous day. But we burned almost a gallon of gas now.
Oh, my God.
I know.
So where are you going from here?
I might go by and pull the crab pot, see how ours are doing.
Okay.
Where are you going to go?
Well, it's so nice, I think I might ride back through the gut.
Oh, okay.
And then come back.
Okay.
I don't know what else to do. I've got plenty of fuel. Okay. All right.
Have fun.
All right, we'll see you in a little bit.
All right.
Okay. There is a dock and a trail over here.
Is there?
Yeah. It's right around that corner, and there's a trail to the bears.
Oh, perfect.
Yeah.
Perfect. I spent the evening with my wife, doesn't it? She's going
to
be safe.
See you later.
Okay.
So we end another wonderful summer at Sullivan Bay, having gone around Vancouver Island and Princess Royal Island, ending up at this beautiful place. I hope you've enjoyed the trip. Please join us on our future ventures.